Yeah, and he's playing this Minor Wallbreakers with the Magic Archer deck that I think he knows how to play extremely well. And as I say that, the miss natal on the tower, and that's tower down. You never want to start like that.
Morton's not celebrating. He's just kind of like, oh, okay, I guess this is how we're doing it.
I think I haven't seen Morton celebrate until he gets first place ever.
And Morton really only has one option. Go to that left-hand lane. Wall breakers to block the tank. Fireball comes in. Will it give enough damage here on that left-hand lane? Miner gets picked up by the skeletons. Zap trying to steal it. Not going to happen. Wow. Morton takes game number one. Morton in the lead. That graveyard push does absolutely nothing. Samuel has to cycle back one more time while also playing some defense. Goes for troop defense here and hopes he can get one more push. Samuel with a big wow. Morton playing a phenomenal game. Samuel waves the white flag. Game number one goes to the jury.
100%, and they're going to know you better than they know other players. And right now, Mitty seems to be knowing what Morton has very, very well. Going to take a drop here from the balloon to activate. There it is. There's the NATO activating King Tower. Oh, my goodness.
It does not. Yeah, I was going to say it's a little bit late on the NATO, and that might cost him a lot. I think that's what we're seeing here. He knows how to play it, and he knows the cycle so well that he's always going to take advantage of every little interaction.
Yep, and the other part of it is he knows how this deck plays, the one on the bottom of your screen, right?
Yeah, once you get enough damage, it doesn't really matter if the Hogs hit or not. He just needs to get those fireballs in. He needs to be careful here because there is a lot of troops, and if that Inferno Tower gets distracted, it could be a problem for him.
Yeah, that Hog Rider getting through the tower. Yeah. One Hog hit in. Oh, man, that was almost it. Log is in. Earthquake won't be enough. There is this Fireball Snowball, but that's also not enough. Now 84 HP remains. 26 on the tower. Log. Where's the log? There's the log. Fireball's in. Morton takes it.
9 hours a day, and then he's practicing as well. So once he gets the confidence in the 1v1 the same way he had it in the team aspect, I think we're going to see a lot of him.
Wallbreaker does escape. Line doesn't pick it up, so... Yeah. Here we are, 2 minutes away, double elixir time, and already Morton with a phenomenal lead, barely touched on his side, trying to find some way to break past those Teslas.
Yeah, and he did force the defensive miner, which is good, right? You're seeing that he's having to force him out of cycle, but at the end of the day, he just has so many little troops that...
How happy is Morton right now to see he's up against Zap in this matchup?
Yeah, it's definitely a good feeling anytime you're playing bait, and the fact that you have a fisherman and he has Hog also is putting a smile on his face, I'm sure.
Protection here for the princess. Goes for the full send. Does Morton. Doesn't get it on tower, though. Mortar here is not going to connect, but no way for the Hog. Is the fisherman going to be there fast enough? Fisherman does get a zap on it.
Yeah.
Beautiful play by Line. GG. Game number three, and it's Minor Wallbreakers for Line.
Yeah, and he's playing this Minor Wallbreakers with the Magic Archer deck that I think he knows how to play extremely well. And as I say that, the miss natal on the tower, and that's tower down. You never want to start like that. So as long as he's aware of that, make sure that he doesn't give anything lined up. With that bomber hit, I think it's over, yeah.
The pocket bomber, not the common way, not a super common play that you see these days, but the pocket bomber plus lightning does take it. And good front and backdrop there for Line to pick up that miner. Valkyrie a little bit high here,
oh
but the
gosh.
Ice Spirit will help stop those pigs.
And the Mortar gets a shot on tower, and that gets the wow out of Line. I don't think anyone thought that Mortar was in the right position, but it locked on something, gets the shot on tower, 358 to 707.
Morton is going to play a little bit of defense, play this one safe, and get the job done.
Yeah, I mean, you talk about all things going Morton's way, and that is a great example of it. Somehow, some way. What? Oh, I was like, where's the earthquake, man? Where is it?
We'll be going to a game three, barring Line disconnecting on his phone here in a couple of seconds, and we'll be seeing a full matchup between these two.
You know, the one thing that I really recognize after watching Morton for so long playing this deck, and again, the minor connections with Line is just fascinating.
I'm not sure. 33 seconds left. 252 on the right-hand side. Knight sets the line high. Cannon cart on defense for Line. Graveyard being defended by a goblin cage and a cannon cart. And the archers go way in the back. Arrows come out for the archers. 394 remaining. We are very close, but right now the ball is in Line's court.
Naked graveyard down low. Snowball on top of the Night Witch. Night Witch is going to have to be met with a bar barrel. There's the bar barrel. There's the fireball. And Morton drops the game in the final moments. We are going to a grand grand finals, my friend.
Yeah, Lion decides not to touch it there, and that's about a 4,000, 5,000 HP change right there, but does get his shots on the bottom. But we are still pretty close. Look at that. Baby wow. Dragon gets on tower, and Morton takes the lead. Zap trying to control here at the bridge. Miner goes to the back, right into the spears. Oh. A Fly Machine gets on tower, and there you go. Morton takes game number one. Yeah, well, he knows he has to get past that cannon cart. Doesn't have any good way to do it here. Fireball in on the archers. Snowball in behind. King Tower does get activated, but skeletons, can they do it? Can one skeleton hit? No, cannot. Oh, he had 1329. Oh. I was completely on the left-hand side. Line takes game number two. Line playing a great game right now. And, you know, going back to the well one more time and trying to get that lineup. This Nato here, defensive, not offensive. EQ gets some damage, and the Magic Archer still gets a shot.
Wow. Yeah, that was so aggressive from Line, but it was also an incredibly calculated play. The fact that he gets a shot in there is shocking. The Hog Rider comes out, which means that they've got to get the log in on those wall breakers.
Wall breakers run right into some troops, cannot get on tower. Log one direction, Miner. Does Morton pick up the Miner this time? No, archers go to the back. Nato making a lot of room here, 203. Log will take that right-hand tower down to 275. Oh my word, does the Hog get a shot?
The Hog Rider picks
it up.
Bomb tower is in, Hog is still alive, 101. Log is in, nothing is there to catch the Miner. There's the Nato, Morton loses by 29 HP.